for just the second and final time in the month of January, the Terriers of Boston University in action here on a Gannis Way. Left side. Porsche got upended. It turns over. Now the Riverhawks race back in. Rister and a save by Abel. And he'll hang on. I think that's the first shot for the Riverhawks here. Turned it to the half wall. Karencik, though, was there. Karencik looking to center one. Backhanded front and a save by Abel. Simone drives it in. Sticked away by Wall. Master Simone gets it back. Skoog with a shift for Phillips and a goal. Ethan Phillips from the far circle on a tic-tac-toe passing play from the Skoog line.
Well, it starts by Rob Master Simone taking the puck out of his own end, generating some offense.
5-on-3 opportunity here. Ferentz, Patrick Harper patiently down low.
Key here is we get nothing, no shots blocked at the blue line.
Zegras curls, get a little daylight to shoot it, and a goal! Trevor Zegras, top shelf, glove side on the wrister. And the Terriers got one, and they got a chance to get more.
You said it, Bernie. Zegras with a little daylight down low. That's something that I would suggest other teams stop doing.
Drops it off for Cockrell. Cockrell to the middle. Ferentz holds. Gives it up to Zegras. He drops it to Ferentz. Harper shifts to the middle. Harper with a wrister and a goal! Patrick Harper from the high, high slot.
Well, you got Lowell's defense moving, like we talked about, Bernie, that east-west play. Hopper and Zegras kind of out high. That three-man weave look that we like to see from the Terriers on the power play.
The Terriers have thrived on taking control of this game. Half wall, left side. Entry for Curry. Slapper save. Rebound! Harper and a goal. Patrick Harper goes up high again to the top shelf.
What are we talking about, Bernie? One time, is it going to be the key to this game offensively for the Terriers?
Fensori down low from the center point. McCarthy back at the point. Fensori in close quarters. Near circle, Skoog, far circle in front, and a tap in for Master Simone on the pass from Phillips. The Terriers get another one.
Terriers offensive puck movement on that power play was the way that Albie draws it up on the board.
So that's going to do it here on a Friday night from Parker Rink and Hockey Night on a Gannis Way. Your final score, Boston University 5 and UMass Lowell nothing.
I thought overall we played a pretty thorough game from the drop of the puck. I thought we forechecked well. I thought we were good through the neutral zone. I thought we defended hard, managed the puck a lot better tonight than many nights. We had many simple plays out there, so it was good to see. It was a really good team win. It's always nice to get a shutout. And I just thought, you know, eventually over time we're gonna score. It was a big play to get that first goal. You know, that was a key moment in the game. And then obviously we got the power play and then the major. We were pretty good at the end there on the power play. So, but I'm really happy for the group. I thought they rebounded pretty well from a tough loss last week. I think it kind of they were enthusiastic, not about losing, but just about our last weekend, and thought we were coming a long way. And we had a good week of practice and good energy, and we had good energy in the game tonight. So we're excited about it and happy for the 2 points. And know tomorrow night's going to be a really tough one in their building.
Mentioned the power play is there and you really clicked there in the third period. What do you think made the difference between the unsuccessful power plays earlier in the game and then obviously the third period?
Well, sometimes it's, you know, it just happens. You know, some are good, some aren't. The one thing we did, we shot the puck. You know, Curry had the puck there, he shot it, and we got a rebound goal. Zegras comes off that high roll and shoots the puck, and we had a good screen. Wasn't anything, you know, spectacular. Last goal we scored was nice. It was a tic-tac-toe, but it's. If we get a shooting mentality with that group, we get enough skill to retrieve it and make plays off it. So we weren't happy with the first one for sure, but it got better as it went. So we're really we're excited. 2 points are in the bank, and we just got to recover and get ready for tomorrow.
No surprise, Tyler Wall is one of the best goalies in this conference. It didn't look like you were going to get one goal, Albie. How surprising are you to chase him and score 4 against him?
It wasn't easy. You know, he was really good, especially in that first period there. We had plenty of chances. Made a couple big ones in the second. And you know what? He's one of the best goalies in the league, and we found a way. We just kept shooting, and we had traffic. The one thing we didn't have in the first period, we didn't have enough traffic on him. He saw a lot of the shots, and as the game wore on, we were able to get to the net a little bit more. So, but he's a terrific goalie, and I'm sure he's going to be sharp tomorrow night, so we're going to have to be ready for it.
Now, is it getting Ashton a shutout in his first home start of his career here?
It's great. It's nice to get a shutout. He played well. I thought he managed the game really well. He was very square. He was very calm. He had a couple, key tie-ups, and made a couple key saves. And I just thought he managed himself and managed the game really well. And it's two good starts in a row for him, so hopefully he can continue that.
How's Logan Cockrell looked in his time getting back into the rotation and back on the ice?
Terrific. It's great having him back. He just adds a different dimension, his speed. We ended up getting that 5-on-3 goal because of his work. He jumped to the corner, won the puck. Zegers comes out on the roll and shoots it in. So he's a big asset. When he was missing, it was the team felt it, and it's nice to get him back. And he's not as sharp as he once was, but he's day by day he's getting better and better, and he's getting a little bit more comfortable with the puck. So it's good to see, and we're going to need him down the stretch here.
Allowed at least 3 goals in each of the past 5 games entering tonight. What do you think made a difference tonight, and how are you going to carry that tomorrow's game?
We didn't turn the puck over a lot tonight. I think our D did a good job of managing the puck in the neutral zone instead of them trying to go end-to-end. They were getting to the red line and putting it in and letting our forwards forecheck. And I just thought we played simple and smart. One of the goals for the game is to play a smart game, and I don't want to say it's the first time this year we've played a smart game, but it's the smartest we've played all year. As far as managing the puck, so that's really good to see, and if we can carry that through the rest of the season, that'll be a big help for our club.